but I am Dr. Gertrude Glossop, PhD, formal drapery, Curtin University. And when Ian was informed that I was conducting the service, he drew Will aside and whispered, "Dear, promise me that Gertrude will wear her best hat and heels, because there'll be a lot who won't." And as I look around the house today, I can see it was absolutely I won't inspect your heels, but I don't think there's a hat in the house. Ian did have a wonderful sense of theatre. Now, as you all know, Ian was an indefatigable activist over many, many years. And he was a great leader in our community, a leader. But his activism was creative and diverse. And I am but one living example of that. I, Gertrude Glossop, am an Ian Purcell creation. And the story goes like this. It was back in 1990, and Ian was helping to organise the Christmas party for the Iranian Society, the Forum for Gay Men's Culture here in Adelaide, of which Ian was a founding committee member. And he said, "My dear, we must have a Queen's message." And that was my genesis. And then a few years later, Ian was instrumental in organising a bus trip of gay men, Uranians, to the little settlement of Urania on your peninsula. Can you imagine that? And why would you go there? But of course, Ian, in his creative way, had decided that there would be a guided tour of Urania, because a certain Mrs. Gertrude Glossop, OBE, farmer's wife, and amateur archaeologist, had discovered the secret hidden history, gay history, of Urania in a rusty, armoured, modern men biscuit tin, crumbling ruins of the village hall. Yes, Ian was very creative in his activism. And then, a few years later, we go to 1997, and it's the first feast. So the organiser of the inaugural feast asked Ian to conduct a gay history walk. And so he said, "I, Gertrude, must lead the walk." And so for the next 10 seasons, Ian, Will, and I developed and conducted the history walks for feast. And I think we're pleased to know that this year I celebrated the 20th season of Feast History Walks, and they're still well attended. So, that's what I'm here and how I came to be. I am indeed a creation of the marvellously creative Ian Purcell. So thank you, dear Ian, for your creative activism. You've shown us how history can, of course, inform and enlighten, but can also entertain and be fun. And I think that's a marvellous message, don't you? And so, from now on, as a tribute to Ian and his inspiration and his pioneering spirit, of course, all future Feast History Walks will be styled the Ian Purcell Memorial Queer History Walks. And now, friends, I'm going to ask our first speaker to come forward. And of course, it is a member of the family, Graham Purcell. And just a little introduction, Graham, if I may, before I hate that you go with the talking stick, you know. Before I hand over the talking stick, I ask all the speakers today to give me a little introduction. Well, Graham is Ian's younger brother, only by 11 months, so they were always very close and shared a lot in common. And in Graham's words, Ian was the tall smarty and Graham was the short arty. So I'll ask Graham to come forward and speak on behalf of his brothers and sisters. Thank you, Graham.